How to find moth nests. Moths are nocturnal creatures that can do significant damage to clothes, plants and food. Discovering damaged clothing can often raise suspicion that you have moths. Moths have various life stages. They are born from eggs and transform from larvae to pupa into adults. The larvae stage is the moth's most damaging stage, because this is when they eat and shred your clothes, carpets and other items. To stop moths in their tracks, proper inspection of your property is required. Things you'll need: sticky moth traps, knife, spatula or nail file, flashlight, magnifying glass. Place sticky moth traps in areas you suspect a moth infestation. Sticky moth traps use a pheromone attractant that attracts the male moths. Once the moths step on the trap, a sticky glue-like substance traps them, and eventually they die. Sticky traps are commonly used to give an indication of where a moth infestation is originating from and how bad the infestation is. Arm yourself with a knife, small spatula or a nail file and a good flashlight and magnifying glass. Head for the room where you caught the most moths in the sticky trap. Inspect your clothes closets with your flashlight. Look on furs and woolen fabrics for traces of moths. Use your knife to lift up pieces of lint and inspect them with your magnifying glass, because moth eggs are only 1/25 inch in size. You may notice the cast skins of the moths, their oval, ivory-colored eggs or the larvae. Keep in mind that if you see a fluttering moth, it doesn't always mean that the larvae are in the same location. The moth may have laid eggs elsewhere in the house. Look through stored items, because moths often attack items that have been stored for a long period of time. Stored upholstered furniture, clothing and old carpets and rugs can all be attacked. Inspect underneath heavy furniture, in cracks and crevices in furniture and around baseboards. Examine storage areas where pet food, seeds, and fertilizer are stored, since these are known to attract moths. Check if there are birds' nests or wasp nests in your attic or under eaves. Moths can settle near these nests because they feed off the leftovers of dead insects that the birds and wasps feed on. Go outdoors and look for larvae on herbaceous plants, twigs, leaves of shrubs and on rotting plant material. Some moths feed on plant sources,